कृष्णा कृष्णा हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल तय गौरा हरि बोल, कलयुग पावन हरिनाम संकीर्तन की, अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की, श्रील प्रभुपाद की, श्री श्री राधा वृंदावन चंद्र की, श्री श्री जगन्नाथ बलदेव सुभद्रा महारानी की, श्री श्री गौर निताय की, श्रीनिवास संकटेश्वर बालाजी की, श्री प्रभुपाद की, ग्रंथराज श्रीमद्भागवतम की। ओम अज्ञान तिमिरंधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुः उन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं। वन्देहं श्रीगुरोः श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवम् साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। नमः ॐ विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे, निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे। नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते, कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामने गौरत्विषे नमः। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगत्पते, गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी, वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च, पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्री वासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय, ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय, ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। नष्टप्रायेषु भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवत्युत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी। कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नन्दनाय च नन्दगोपकुमाराय गोविन्दाय नमो नमः। We are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 18th chapter, text number 7.
Nanu dveshti kalim samrat,
सारंगैव सारभोग कुशलान्याशु सिद्ध्यन्ति नेतराणि कृतानि यत् नानु द्वेष्टि कलिं सम्राट् सारंगैव सारभोग कुशलान्याशु सिद्ध्यन्ति नेतराणि कृतानि यत् नानु द्वेष्टि कलिं सम्राट् सारंगैव सारभोग कुशलान्याशु सिद्ध्यन्ति नेतराणि कृतानि यत् नानु द्वेष्टि कलिं सम्राट् सारंगैव सारभोग कुशलान्याशु सिद्ध्यन्ति नेतराणि कृतानि यत् न नव अनुद्वेष्टि एनवीएस कलिम अंड टू द पर्सनालिटी ऑफ कली सम्राट द एम्परर सारंग ए रियलिस्ट लाइक द बी इव लाइक सारभुक् वन हू एक्सेप्ट्स द सब्सटेंस कुशलानी ऑस्पिशियस एक्ट्स आशु इमीडिएटली सिद्ध्यन्ति बिकम सक्सेसफुल न नेवर इतराणि विच आर इनऑस्पिशियस कृतानि बीइंग परफॉर्म्ड यत् एज मच एज ट्रांसलेशन परपोर्ट बाय हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एस भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी प्रभुपाद की महाराज परीक्षित वॉज रियलिस्ट लाइक द बी हू एक्सेप्ट ओनली द एसेंस ऑफ अ फ्लवर ही न्यू परफेक्टली वेल दैट इन दिस एज ऑफ कली ऑस्पिशियस एक्ट्स प्रोड्यूस गुड इफेक्ट्स इमीडिएटली whereas inauspicious acts must be actually performed to render effects. So he was never envious of the personality of Kali. Purport. The age of Kali is called the fallen age. In this fallen age, because the living beings are in an awkward position, the Supreme Lord has given some special facilities to them. So by the will of the Lord, a living being does not become a victim of a sinful act until the act is actually performed. In other ages, simply by thinking of performing a sinful act, one used to become a victim of the act. On the contrary, a living being in this age is awarded with the results of pious acts simply by thinking of them. Maharaj Parikshit, being the most learned and experienced king by the grace of the Lord, was not unnecessarily envious of the personality of Kali, because the king did not intend to give him any chance to perform any sinful act. The king protected his subjects from falling prey to the sinful acts of the age of Kali, and at the same time, he gave full facility to the personality of Kali by allotting him some particular places. At the end of the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said that even though all nefarious activities of the personality of Kali are present, there is a great advantage in the age of Kali. One can attain salvation simply by chanting the holy name of the Lord. Thus, Maharaj Parikshit made an organized effort to propagate the chanting of the Lord's holy name, and thus he saved the citizens from the clutches of Kali. It is for this advantage only that great sages sometimes wish all good for the age of Kali. In the Vedas, also it is said that by discourse on Lord Krishna's activities, one can get rid of all the disadvantages of the age of Kali. In the beginning of the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is also said that by the recitation of Srimad Bhagavatam, the Supreme Lord becomes at once arrested within one's heart. These are some of the great advantages of the age of Kali. And Maharaj Parikshit took all the advantages and did not think any ill of the personality of Kali, true to his Vaishnava cult. So I have prepared a PowerPoint, which I will show you now. This verse is so important because we are living in which age? The age of Kali. So, how to live in this age in such a way that we can take full advantage and go back home, back to Godhead. So, therefore, how to be a realist like the bee? So, see the first point. Be a realist like the bee. So, in this verse, Saranga Yuva, Sarabhuk, it is said. Saranga is, Sara means the honey,
ग मीन्स गमयति सो सारम ग सारम ग इट टेक्स द हनी एंड फ्लाइज दैट्स व्हाई इट्स कॉल्ड सारंग द बी इज कॉल्ड फारंग सारंग सिमिलरली द डिवोटी ऑफ द लॉर्ड नोस ही इज अ वेरी गुड एसेंस कलेक्टर इन लाइफ वॉट इज द एसेंस कलेक्टर ही ऑलवेज लुक्स फॉर द गुड एंड नेवर talks about the bad. Wherever there is good, he goes there to collect the essence and he moves. A honeybee does not hover over the bush, but it sits in the flower and takes the honey, which means it gets into activity. You will see that. That is very important. Sometimes people can talk the glories of Bhagavatam, how wonderful Bhagavatam is, and they can purchase a whole set of Bhagavatam and stack it in their cupboard. And sometimes they may flip through a few pages of this canto or that canto. That is like hovering. But actually, drinking the honey means get into it fully. Read it, remember it, relish it, repeat it. So in this way, the bee never hovers over rubbish things, which means the bee is able to see both good and bad. Otherwise, how can it avoid the rubbish things? To avoid rubbish things, you have to see rubbish things. But after seeing the rubbish things, you avoid it, knowing that this is not my focus, this is not my concentration, this is not going to do any good for me. So, with that understanding, the honeybee does not hover over rubbish things. It watches both and it goes away. As bee is taking the essence of a flower, it is acting on it and not just hovering, as I told you just now. And a fly is never found near a flower, you see. A fly is so busy and preoccupied going to the area where people pass stool. It has no time for anything else. All its time is spent only for that. So the nature of the fly is to be all the time around the dirt, picking dirt, carrying the dirty rubbish things and putting it on others. These two are spoken in one verse. Makshika vrinamichanti madumichanti madupaha. Madupa is the honeybee. Makshika is the fly. So, makshika vrinam ichanti. The flies are fond of stool. Madum ichanti madupa. He says, and the honeybee is very fond of the honey. So, what is honey or what is nectar? Krishna's glories are nectar. Devotee's glories are nectar. Any special understanding of Krishna's behavior or Krishna's activity, which is not commonly known to devotees, somebody is carrying a nectar and then you also gather that nectar. Recently I collected one amazing nectar, I will tell you. This is called nectar. Why, Balaram is called Duryodhan Guru? We have this question now. Why Duryodhan, why Balaram is actually Krishna's expansion, but he sort of favors Balaram? This question I always used to have. Recently got a nectar to read. He says that there are some people who will always try to hover around the Guru or stay around the Guru, but actually they will not obey Guru. They will be doing something independent, but they will stay near the Guru in order to be popular. But the Guru is not pleased with them. At the same time, the Guru does not reject them also. The Guru is extremely merciful. Therefore, he gives them the mercy of his association, hoping that this person will reform. At the same time, the Guru also is not pleased with their attitude and behavior. But he tolerates it. So that is how Duryodhana was. One time, Balaram had to chastise Duryodhana very strongly for talking ill of the Yadu dynasty, as if Yadu dynasty is like the chapal, trying to sit on the head, something like that they said. So Balram wanted to put whole Hastinapur in the river, like that. So there are devotees who are far away from the Guru, but who are faithfully serving. There are devotees who are very close to Guru, who are also faithfully serving and the Guru. But there are some people who stay very close to Guru, but control the Guru and control the people coming to Guru, both. And by such kind of control, they try to increase their prestige and increase their self-importance. So, one such person was Duryodhan. And he was apparently entertained by Balram, but in the true sense, he is not a close associate of Balram. Like there is one as Gaur Govind Maharaja said. So, this is nectar. This is wonderful nectar it is. Similarly, I had a question in mind. That is, mic is working? Yes. No, its volume is reduced. Is coming properly? Okay. Hare Krishna. So, I had a question that Droma Raj, when he went to meet Kubera, he is offering a prayer, and Kubera is telling Dhruva, ask me for any benedictions you want. Now, I thought, who is saying to whom? Kubera is a demigod and Dhruva is a pure devotee. Demigods are way below pure devotees. Pure devotees are way above. How can a demigod offer any benediction to a pure devotee? So you'll be amazed in Shastra, even a devotee can offer blessings to Lord also. Pallanda, Pallanda, Pallayiragam, Thanda, Palagodi, Nurand, one great Vaishnava Acharya is telling the Lord, oh Lord, may you live very, very long life. He is saying, Lord lives eternal life, but he is giving blessing to Lord that you live a very long life. So, the devotees innocently have love for the Lord, and with that love, if they give blessing, Lord doesn't mind accepting. And that is for the same reason you find in Mahabharata, Varuna Dev comes and gives a chakra in gift to Krishna, Sudarshan chakra. Do you think if Varuna doesn't give Sudarshan chakra to Krishna, poor Krishna will not have a chakra? He is all the time having chakra within himself. Anytime he can release to kill Shishupal. But when devotees give blessings or gift, Lord accepts it. Isn't it? Like that, pure devotees sometimes offer blessings to the Lord. Similarly, Kubera was eager to give blessing to Dhruva. And Dhruva told him, please give me the blessings that I will attain pure devotional service. And that was another mind-boggling thing for me. How can a demigod award the blessing of pure devotional service to him? Demigods themselves have material desires. Then I found His Grace, Burijan Prabhu gave a beautiful explanation. He said, Dhruva Maharaj is already on the way to attain pure devotional service, but there was a stumbling block which came on the way. Big, it's like you want to go through Lonavala to Mumbai. And from the mountain due to slide, what do you call that slide? Landslide. Due to landslide, a big rock has fallen on your road. Now you want to reach Bombay. Once this rock is moved, you can go ahead to Bombay. Similarly, the block, landslide block which came in Dhruva's life was his offense to the Yakshas. So, Yakshas are all, Swayambhamanu says they are Punya Janan because they are actually worshippers of Shiva and also they are assistants of our Kubera. So, they should not be wholesale killed because one of them made a mistake and you are killing all of them. So now Dhruva felt I committed a mistake. Now he told our Kubera that you bless me that I will attend pure devotion service. That means what? You bless me that I can go to Bombay now. What is the meaning of that? That means remove this stone block. Because this block has come, I have offended you a man. Therefore you all are displeased with me. Now become pleased with me in such a way that I will be able to go ahead in my spiritual life. So immediately Kubera said, since you have obeyed your grandfather's words, and you obeyed my words also, I am very pleased with you and I bless you that you go ahead attaining pure devotion service, which means I remove the stumbling block and you can go ahead. What a beautiful understanding, isn't it? So in this way, we should always be collecting nectar and sharing with others in Krishna consciousness. So by doing this, we feel a deep sense of relish and satisfaction. And we can also satisfy others in blissful Krishna consciousness. On the other hand, the fly is always found around the dirt, is going and sitting, makshika vrinam ichanti. Ichanti means they desire to look for some politics. They are fly-like people are looking for something political, something dirty, something, some interesting gossip about others. So that they can actually spread it around to people, go around telling others, do you know what happened to this fellow, what happened to that fellow? So then when we speak such rubbish things, we become vehicles of rubbish things. We carry rubbish things, then we become exactly like the flies. And such people actually become agents in the hand of Kali. Because Kali actually is famous for fault finding and criticism. So we become agents in the hand of Kali to spread impurity. Instead of becoming an agent in the hand of Lord Nityananda to spread the preaching of Krishna consciousness. So this is one warning for all of us. We have to be realist like the bee. That means be a nectar collector. That is the first point. Second point, accepting degrading nature of Kali Yuga. Now what is the meaning of accepting the degrading nature? We should not be in the sky. We should be realistic about the degradation that is around us in the age of Kali Yuga. Like we say, you know, Prabhu, don't hover in the clouds, have your legs on the ground. You can have head in the clouds, but your legs should be on the ground. What is the meaning of that? Because we do not know sufficiently the nature of Kali Yuga by studying the Srimad Bhagavatam, oftentimes we have too high expectations from others. For example, in the Bhagavatam it is said, Tatashchana dinam dharma satyam shaucham dayakshama kalena balina rajan nankshati ayuhu balam smriti. He is saying that as the Kali Yuga progresses, anudinam, day by day, one will observe satyam, that means truthfulness, shaucham, cleanliness, compassion and forgiveness duration of life and bodily strength and remembrance, all these things will gradually go down day by day. Not only these things, the people will be manda sumanda matayo manda bhagyahi upadrutaha prayen alpayush sabya kalavasmin yuge jana. There also he says alpayush, they will have very short duration of life, they will have no interest in spiritual life, manda, they will be the education system will ruin them and create faithlessness in them. They are most unfortunate because they have to slog very hard for their daily bread, the age of Kali Yuga. And they will be bombarded with cinemas, movies, internet, dirty cinema magazines, and such kinds of impure things that innocent, gullible jivas will partake of those things and get completely destroyed. The age of Kali Yuga, that is a great misfortune. Therefore, they are called as, nissatvan. The word nissatvan is used. They will not have any sattva at all. So, kshinayush means their age will be reduced and their bala will be. So, Prabhupada says in Kali Yuga, the main problem is their bad habits of eating habits, sleeping habits, recreation habits. Because of this, one gets very degraded. So if you can bring the people to ISKCON and then polish their habits and award them clean habits and they also accept it, very quickly we can bring them out of the ill effects of Kali, Prabhupada says. So in this way, Kali has many bad habits, and the four prominent bad habits are mentioned in Kali. People will be hypocritical. And when they are hypocritical, you point out, they will become very angry and they will quarrel. And then when they quarrel, you ask them, how can you quarrel? Then they will rebel against the authority. And then after rebelling against the authority, they will become independent. So hypocrisy, quarrel, rebelling and independent. So these are characteristics of the age of Kali. So therefore, what is meaning of accepting the degrading nature of Kali Yuga means, if someone is nice to you in this age, you should be greatly surprised. And after being very nice with you, if somebody doesn't backstab you, you should be even more surprised. Because there are people, they will pretend to be nice to you. They will speak very sweet words to you. Oh, Prabhu, you gave a very wonderful class. Oh, Prabhu, you are so nice, you did this. Oh, Prabhu, I am very thankful to you, you did that. Many people say in this world very nice things. Like one devotee was praising another fellow. I said, oh, you appreciated so well. He said, no, just like that, you know, we are supposed to say that. So I said, he was telling. So many people actually are not genuine from the heart. They just speak very upari-upar, superficial. So that is very nature of this age. But if somebody is really genuine, they speak from the heart, they honestly, they don't backstab you, they speak to you properly, then you should know actually, it's a very surprising thing. Actually, if anything works in this age, it is surprising. So that is the meaning of knowing the degrading nature of Kali Yuga. That means everything degrades in this age. Truthfulness degrades. All the good qualities, like if you read the 12th canto, it says the brahmanas, you know, will be taking salary. The man-woman's attraction will be based simply on superficial look. If a woman is good-looking, man will be mad after her. If a man is making money, woman will be ready to run with him. In this way, woman will be ready to leave one husband and run with another husband, another man, if the man has more money and things like that. And in this way, the degradation in Kali Yuga is enormous. And there will be Varna Sankara. So in this way, it's a very degrading age. We should not expect anything very big in this age. And we should know that we are living in a very dangerous age, degrading age. Everywhere there are dangerous things happening. And we should see the world around us with the eye of the Shastra, Shastra Chakshu. And be mentally prepared. See, if you don't have a big expectation, say you are going to Prasadam Hall at 2:30, you don't expect anything big. You expect there will be rice and dal. But amazingly, apart from rice and dal, one devotee brings you 4 chapatis and sabji also. You will be very grateful. But if you have a big expectation, today is Tuesday, you know, it's a big feast, and that should be sweet also and everything, and you go at 2:30 only, you know, rice, dal, sabji, chapati is there, you will be blaming, oh, why is sweet is not there, isn't it? So, actually, knowing the degrading nature of Kali Yuga means to be aware of the degradation that Shastras are explaining about. When Prabhupada went to America, you know, they kept the potatoes of Prabhupada in a fridge where there was also meat. So they told Prabhupada later on, sorry Prabhupada, we kept it along with meat. Prabhupada said, forget it. You know, he didn't mind it because he understood the age of Kali, what to do. These things you have to tolerate. And Kali Yuga people don't know what is proper, what is right, what is wrong. Many people don't know basic things, basic standards of cleanliness also people don't know. So, if you are going to be very particular about, oh, this is not there, that is not there, this is not happening, that's not happening, then we will become very disturbed. But if we anticipate that Kali Yuga has many deficiencies, Prabhupada had to work with people who had no training in sanskaras, purificatory ceremonies, and he had to work with them. They were the manpower available for Prabhupada. So you can imagine how much tolerant he was. So be grateful if something works in this age. Thirdly, take advantage of the age of Kali. You know very well that inauspicious acts must be actually performed to have the effect, he says. Na itarani kritani yat, he says, no? That doesn't mean that, you know, we can think of any sinful act. In the 9th chapter of 1st canto, Bhishma says that if you think anything bad, you will naturally, you know, you will feel bad about it, and then, I mean, you will develop feelings for the bad thing, and eventually you will indulge in the bad thing. Thinking, so the thinking in the mind happens because of the jnanendriyas gathering and giving to mind. In Kali Yuga, the jnanendriyas, namely 5, eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin, they gather a lot of bad information from outside and it gives to the mind. And the mind is munching on it. And if somebody doesn't give it up, Then the mind will order the acting senses, namely the hands, legs, genitals, rectum and speech, to act it out. Mind will ask to act. So, but at the same time, if it remains in the mental platform alone, it is not punishable in Kali Yuga. But if somebody maintains it in mental platform, then it will turn into action, like the Bhishma says. On the other hand, auspicious acts are counted as done if you simply desire to do them. So, Parikshit Maharaj taught all the citizens that even if there is some impure thought coming in your mind as a input to your mind by observing something bad, you, if it comes into your head, into your mind, just tolerate it. Shaknoti hai vajasodum praksharire vimokshanat. He says, no? Kama krodod babam viddi sayukta sasuki narah. Krishna says, till last breath one should tolerate the vegams of kama krodha loba. By tolerating the veg, one will not incur sin in Kali Yuga. So one should know this is the advantage in Kali Yuga. If we happen to be in the previous Yugas, even in the mind, if we contemplated something bad, immediately it's punishable. The practical proof is, you know, Renuka, wife of Parashuram. Today is Parashuram's birthday also, appearance day. So, Parashuram's mother Renuka went to the riverside. In the water reflection, she saw a Gandharva flying in the sky. Just momentary thought came in her mind that, oh, what a handsome person or something. Then she lost her chastity. Chastity became bhanga. So she could not make that mud pot which she would make every day. So she returned back home with empty hands, and her husband Jamadagni understood that she has thought something impure in her mind. So she told his sons, cut off her head. So of course the 2-3 sons refused. Then he made them all into pishach. Then told Parashuram, Parashuram, cut her head off. So he took the Parashu and cut off her head immediately. And of course, Parashuram after that was blessed by his father for 3 boons. So he asked the first boon, let my mother come back to life, but then forget that I cut her neck. That was one of the boons he asked. And then let my brothers also come back to life and not be a pishach. Like that. I think on the second boon was that let my mother forget. So like the 3 boons he asked. And my mother came back to life. But the point remains, that because she contemplated on something impure, she was given the punishment at that time. Simply for thinking also. Imagine if we were punished for our thinking, we don't know how much punishment we will get. We have to remain in hell for a very long, long period of time. So Kali Yuga, that's the advantage of Kali Yuga. So therefore, we should desire to do auspicious acts, and we should actually do auspicious acts, and we should go on multiplying that and take advantage of the age of Kali. Yeah, this is the 4th point here. Be practical and positive. 2 P's, remember. Be practical and be positive. Instead of wasting time in concentrating on the ill effects of Kali, which is already given in the Shastra, Parikshit actually concentrated on creating organized efforts to propagate chanting of holy names. What is the meaning of being practical? To come to pure devotion service, we can't do it in a day. That's a saying in English, Rome was not built in a day. So some people say, Prabhuji, how can I avoid offenses? It's not an overnight thing. You know, Prabhuji, how can I, attain Nishtha stage? How can I overcome Anartha Nirvriti very quickly and attain Nishtha stage? It's not overnight. Do it gradually. First start with some engagement. So when you get some seva engagement, then you are rendering service. Then when rendering service, you get some taste of service, you render more service. Then devotees see you rendering service, they bless you. Then collect blessings. When more blessings come, you know, then the heart becomes more cheerful and more joyful, render more service. In this way, like we say, small drops of water make an ocean. Like that, little by little by little, we can accumulate blessings, accumulate service opportunity, and we can grow very nicely. And we may not become a pure devotee immediately. In Kali Yuga, there are many stumbling blocks. So we have to be patient. Like you have seen people in the morning time who go to Hinjabadi from any area of Pune, they know very well that there are going to be a lot of vehicles. Correct, no? There will be a lot of vehicles. And because of those vehicles, they have to move inch by inch, little by little, they have to move. And it's an everyday thing. They know it. They are mentally prepared for it. They know that this is the time I go to office and this is the time there is a traffic jam. And it is an everyday phenomenon. You know, I reach office in 1.5 hours every day. They know it very well. On the contrary, those people who drive the same car in the morning, in 20 minutes you will reach there. But that is pure devotee. Pure devotee has no blockages. He can zoom, immediately he can go. So pure devotee may advance very fast, but we are not able to advance because we have many blockages in our system. We have ego problem, we have offense committing problem, we have laziness problem, we have duplicitous problem, we have lie telling problem. So many different problems are there. They are all blockages in the traffic. Inch by inch we are progressing. So what is the meaning of being practical? Try to do something constructive to make inch by inch progress. Render service, seek blessings, attain more taste of service. So, Parikshit was aware that Krishna has left the world and Kali has come in. And he is here to stay. He is not going to go away till the end of the age of Kali Yuga, which is 4,27,000 years. He is not going to go away. Kali is right here. But the only advantage is somehow if we can think something auspicious or do something auspicious, effect is immediate. So in the presence of Kali, one should remember this, that I have a lot of limitations in the age of Kali and I should not try to lose my enthusiasm because I am not able to zoom, go in the road fast and attain Krishna Prema. Like one devotee had asked a question, Prabhu, when Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, Jagai Madai, simply by one embrace they attained love of God. Prabhu, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave even love of God to a Muslim tailor who was in Shivas's house. Mahaprabhu gave love of God to the dog of Shivananda Sen. Now at least we are also dog of our spiritual master. Why are we not getting love of God? We are losing enthusiasm. That's the point. We should not lose enthusiasm. We have to know that Kali is right here. And Mahaprabhu came for a short time and gave like sample soap to attract and charm all our hearts and he went away. Now Krishna is out, Kali is in this age of Kali Yuga. But although Krishna has gone back to Godhead, he has left behind Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam is the best substitute in the place of Krishna here. By reading Bhagavatam, Uru Vicharasi Swanaha, it is said, Krishna will emerge from the pages of Bhagavatam and enter into our hearts. And we can place Krishna in our hearts by the study of Bhagavatam. So in this way, be practical, be realistic. Don't imagine that overnight we can become pure devotees. Don't get discouraged. Be enthusiastic, be patient. That is the point. That's the meaning of being practical. And being positive means, when you see this cock, it's making the sound. And it is sorting out from the dustbin the rice particles and the stones. It will keep on moving like this. Stones one side and rice particles other side. It will do like you have seen that. So at the end you will find lot of rice it has accumulated. Same in Kali Yuga also. What will be anukul for my bhakti, put it one side. What will be pratikul for my bhakti, put it other side. Then you put a circle and delete it. And take only what is anukul and go on. And then meditate on the favorable thing and do the favorable thing and go on with your life. That is being positive. Be practical and be positive. Then accept the essence. It's called Sarabhuk. Saranga Iva Sarabhuk. Those who accept the nature of the world, they don't waste time. They concentrate on devotional service. Those who expect things from this world, they become disappointed. Parikshit was a realist, he did not become upset that the age of Kali has come. Don't allow the ill effects to sit in our hearts. And Parikshit had no time for Kali. He was busy organizing preaching, he says. So, here he says that, earlier also I made this point, that do not have big expectations from this world, especially in this day and age, because if you have expectations, you will become disappointed. That was earlier point we made. But here additional point is being made, while not having expectations, big expectations from the people and things and around us in the age of Kali, we also should accept the essence. That means we should not be careless in accepting the essence. For example, आदौ गुरु पादाश्रय सद्धर्म पृच्छा विश्रम्भेण गुरो सेवा साधु वर्तमान वर्तमान कृष्ण दीक्षादि शिक्षण. सो दीज आर ऑल प्रिस्क्राइब्ड बाय रूप गोस्वामी. राइट इन द बिगिनिंग वन शुड एक्सेप्ट अ स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर. आदो गुरु पादाश्रय सद्धर्म पृच्छा इंक्वायर फ्रॉम हिम कृष्ण दीक्षादि शिक्षण एक्सेप्ट दीक्षा एंड शिक्षा फ्रॉम हिम प्रॉपरली. डोंट नेग्लेक्ट द शिक्षा एंड साधु वर्तमान वर्तमान असोसिएट विद सेंटली पीपल. Don't be careless about it. Don't neglect reading, don't neglect hearing, don't neglect associating. Many times we find ourselves surrounded by varieties of opportunities for getting association and purifying and improving. Still we are very careless and neglectful. Just like a child wants to play all day, he never wants to touch the school book. He never wants to read, never wants to get good marks in the exam. Although the parents are providing facility, like my father used to not only provide the school textbook, he would go to the market and bring all the notes available in the market for one subject. Like for science, he'll bring 3-4 different company publications notes. I would tell my father, why are you spending so much money and I won't have time to read all of them? You know what he would say? Okay, whichever one you like, you read first, and then if time permits, you can read the others also, so that you get a broader understanding. Like that he would say. Similarly, now in ISKCON you're fine. You know, you want to read Bhagavatam or Bhagavad Gita, immediately there are so many study guides Gauranga Priya Prabhu has produced for Bhagavad Gita. You know, Subodhini guide Gauranga Darshan Prabhu has produced now. It's available. Like that you find there is a North American guide available. Sutapa Prabhu from London has produced a guide with acronyms and everything. You know, adding to all this, now we have Gita Rahasyam now, PPTs are available now. So you will find when you want to do something, study, there is a lot of support. Still, we often become like naughty children. We are seeing from a distance. Okay, whether to take or not, I will think and tell you. We are very careless about the auspicious things that are all around us. There is opportunity for service, opportunity for study, opportunity for association, opportunity for performing bhakti sukriti. Actually, in the Vedic times, you want sadhus, you have to go to the forest to meet a saintly person and inquire. Similarly, if you have to go to Pandharpur and all, you have to walk. People would walk to Pandharpur to go and take darshan of Vittal. You have to go to like Vrindavan to Mayapur. Srinivas Acharya walked practically 3 months, 4 months they walk to go to one holy place in those days. Now everything is available, you know, at our fingertips. Just go to the computer and book a flight ticket and push, you know, fly and come. So, but we oftentimes don't have that eagerness or enthusiasm. Therefore, he says, accept the essence. Don't be neglectful. Don't be careless. Because if you are careless, you will lament later. Why? Because the death will come eventually one day. Like recently, one devotee was just 27 years old. Suddenly, he got a heart attack and he passed away. Just 27 years old. So, now I thought, my Lord, I am 50 now. I have lived 23 extra years. So, therefore, every year you are living more than other people are passing. You should remember that this is like a bonus time given to me. Let me make myself Krishna conscious. So, when mercy is available all around us, one should not close one's eyes to the mercy foolishly. As well as Japataka Maharaj told this story. He said, one boy was sleeping in a room with windows and doors closed. The father was battering the door. Beta, get up! Your school bus is coming at 8:30. It's already 8 o'clock. You have to take a bath, take your breakfast and catch the bus. The boy said, Papa, let the sun rise first. Then I will get up. Father said, what are you saying? Sun has already risen. It is up in the sky. You can see it in the sky shining. But for seeing the sun, you have to open the window, open the door. Then you can see. And you are inside the four blankets covering yourself saying that let the sun rise. Sun has already risen, he said. That is our situation also. We put ourselves and inside the blankets and close the window and doors and not access and accept and approach the mercy available in various forms and varieties. Accept the essence. So we have to tell our mind, you rascal mind, accept the mercy available. Don't be lethargic. Don't be passionate. We are passionate after so many things in this age that we oftentimes miss out on the mercy available very naturally, easily for us. We are passionate to eat too much and go to sleep. we are passionate to do many activities without accepting the merciful forms in which Lord comes. He comes as the holy rivers, the holy sthalams, the holy books and the holy devotees, the holy deity, the holy name. And then sixth one, be Krishna conscious, not Kali conscious. See, when we think ill of others, we don't understand who has walked into our hearts. Kali has walked, he says. Kali and Krishna both start with K. So be careful. K, when you say, are you going to say Kali or are you going to say Krishna, is in your hands. Sometimes we think we are Krishna conscious, but we may be pulled into becoming Kali conscious. How? Sometimes we actually are talking something very nice to a devotee. Something from Shastra, from Prabhupada pastimes, this and that. But sometimes even while talking to devotees, while talking about good about someone, some bad also comes in the mouth along with that. That's why to understand good, we must be realistic and know what is bad also. We can't close our eyes. Parikshit stopped Kali by stopping fault-finding, criticism and made efforts to propagate chanting. Because our mouth is constantly speaking faults and criticisms due to the influence of the age of Kali. And the Kali enters the tongue of the people and speaks very strong criticisms and faults without even knowing the truth properly. So, one of the easiest ways to stop the tongue from entertaining criticism and fault-finding and blaming and mourning and wailing and pointing fingers and everything is to keep ourselves busy in positive activities by keeping ourselves Krishna conscious. So we have to, this is one thing that's being said here, know what is good, what is bad, be fully aware and know that dwelling on bad will lead to Kali, dwelling on good will lead to Krishna consciousness. And this is sixth point is very tough because to avoid a prajalpa and to glorify Krishna, this point is not very easy. Oftentimes due to our old bad habit, we resort to rumor mongering, gossiping, blaspheming, fault finding. So for this you have to be very conscious and alert, and as soon as tongue starts vibrating something useless, immediately we should stop the tongue and vibrate about Krishna. And the last one, blame yourself. What is this blaming ourselves? Generally you hear that don't blame others, don't blame yourself. But this is coming from the verse, famous verse. Tattenu kampam susamikshamano bunjanaye vatmakritam vipakam hritvakpapurbirvida dannamaste jivetayo mukti padesadaya bhak. He is telling that tatte anukampa, oh my dear Lord Krishna, I am always aspiring for your mercy. So samikshamano means longing for the Lord's mercy. Bhunjana eva atmakritam vipakam. I have committed so many mistakes and blunders in my life, in the past life and present life. Whatever suffering is coming in my life is all due to my own mistakes. And hrit vak vapur vir vidadan namaste. With body, mind and words, I will offer obeisances at your lotus feet. And for such a person in this consciousness, he is the rightful heir for attaining Lord's mercy, it says. So here he says, what are the three reasons why you should say sorry? It's common sense and right thing to do if you know that you have committed mistake. Correct, no? So you can go and say, Prabhu, I am sorry. But in case you are not very sure whether you did mistake or somebody else did mistake, you can still say sorry, because later on that person finds that mistake was his, he will come and tell you, sorry sir Prabhuji, it was not your mistake, it was my mistake. But when you say sorry, even before knowing whether you are wrong or not, that is considered a sign of humility. But when you know very well that you are right, mistake is not yours, but the other person is not yet convinced, you can have a heated argument, and that heated argument will lead to Kali, and Kali entering the scene. So in order to maintain the relationship and maintain the sweetness of the relation, so what do you do? To avoid ego clashes, we tell the devotee, okay Prabhu, I'm sorry. So he may be happy that you said sorry, but internally he will come to know eventually that he was wrong and you were right. One amazing thing in this world is, as soon as you accept the blame, everything ends. There is silence, you will see. So you want silence, sometimes, okay Prabhu. Actually, you will see there are certain instances where two people have contributed to a mistake. For example, say a water tank is overflowing. One devotee is telling another devotee, Prabhuji, go and switch off the motor. And that devotee tells a third devotee, Prabhu, please switch on the motor. And the third devotee says that, Prabhuji, don't you see I am on phone? You are asking me to switch off the motor, I have to complete the phone call, it's a very important phone. But still I will tell somebody. So he tells a fourth devotee to switch off the motor. Now the fourth devotee didn't hear well. What, Prabhuji, switch off the light? Okay, I have switched off the light. So he switched off the room light. He didn't hear properly. Now the water is still flowing. Now the leader is angry. He is saying, Prabhu, I told you to switch off the motor. Now another half an hour the water is flowing. You are wasting Krishna's water. Do you have any common sense? That devotee becomes very angry. Prabhu, how do you say I didn't switch off? I told another devotee to switch off. And they both are having a heated argument. But you understand that he made an effort to do, but it didn't happen at the end. So these are all ways in which Kali will enter the devotee relationships. Actually, sometimes two people will be saying the same thing slightly differently, and they'll be having a heated argument. So therefore, he says that it's better that you take the blame on you. Okay, Prabhuji, blame is on me because I told you to stop the water, stop the motor, but I didn't check whether you did or not. Okay, I'm sorry, I told the wrong person, okay. You told the wrong person, you mean I am bad? Okay, you are not bad. Okay, I should not have told you, okay, Prabhuji. Isn't it? Sometimes anything you say, you become, you are captured in a quarrel. That means you have to say, you are good also, and you would have switched off also, you did the right thing by passing on to others. Actually, I should have switched off myself, but I made a mistake of telling others, I'm sorry, or whatever. So sometimes you can see heated arguments in any place, whether it be a home, it be office, it be even temple, any place, if you are not careful, immediately there can be social discord or quarrel between a group of people in Kali. So be aware, such kinds of quarrel. Immediately, if you don't put petrol in fire, it will grow more. So these seven headings along with the wonderful subpoints I got from His Holiness Mahavishnu Maharaj's lectures on this lecture. So Mahavishnu Maharaj speaks very beautifully. Devotees have extracted the points, and I really liked it because very deep it is. Very deep discussion on how to be a realist. So this is a topic. Be a realist like the bee. You got 7 points for application in your life, and today is Akshaya Tritiya day, very auspicious day on which many things happen. Acharnupu has given me a list. Draupadi received Akshaya Patra from Surya Devata. So whenever I say one, you have to say one. Hari Bol, okay? Hari Bol. Treta Yuga begins today. Prayagraj and all the holy rivers and holy places come to Pavan Sarovar and Nandagaon to take bath, where Nanda Maharaj saw that situation and he cancelled his pilgrimage to Prayagraj because all the holy rivers are in Nandagaon. Hari Bol. And Parashuram's birthday, appearance day today. Hari Bol. And the most holy Ganga appears on earth today. And Vyasadeva starts writing Mahabharata today. Kubera received wealth and the position of custodian of the wealth of the demigods. Padrikashram gates opens today. Because in cold winter it is closed. Now it is open now, from today onwards. Madhavendrapuri Chandan Yatra for 21 days begins from today. Hari Bol. Indra Dumna Maharaj started Chandan Yatra for Jagannath at Puri. Hari Bol. And Sudama met Krishna today in Dwaraka. And Jagannath Puri Ratayatra preparation begins today for the chariot construction. Hari Bol. Can you imagine how auspicious day is today? It's called Akshaya Tritiya. So Akshaya means no diminution. So today I thought of speaking on this topic of be a realist like the bee, so that we make a very positive and very constructive approach in our spiritual life, so that all devotees let their bhakti keep ever growing. Karmi people are starting their business today to grow the business, And our vyavasaya is Krishna consciousness. So let our Krishna consciousness grow more and more in very big proportion, attracting the attention of Krishna to come and reside in our hearts. Mantra Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Srila Prabhupada ki, Gaur Bhaktavrinda ki. Thank you very much.